Yeah, we've been Willow too, Dr. Data News coming at you. Okay, I am an American state national. I'm not a United States citizen. I've expatriated in every name that I ever carried in this life, from Carol Lee Bohannon to Carol Lee Roberts, Carol Lee Hicks, and every derivative thereof, has all been copyrighted. So the infringement of copyright is $10,000 first offense, $1 million on the second offense, and $10 million if done three times within 1 year. And everybody has surpassed that by leaps and bounds. We've been Willow 2, Daily Data News coming at you. All right, this is a declaration of political status that has been recorded, okay, and the seal, embossed seal right there with the Assembly, Kentucky Assembly, which I'm a member of. So anyhow, we're going to go these pages one at a time. And it seems like the LEOs want to dispel and dismiss writing the American state national off as a sovereign citizen. Whoever that outfit is absolutely an idiot. You cannot be a sovereign on the land and soil and be a citizen same. It's an oxymoron. All right, so anyway, this is with the Kentucky Assembly recording. And this, all of my papers, documents, had already been recorded in Georgia in the public record. So now it is with the Kentucky Assembly recording. So, anyhow, on land and soil. Okay, so anyway, it's in the record. And this is all of what I recorded, or they recorded. All right, so on to the next page. Their receipt of my payment to have it recorded. A second time, because I expatriated and became an American state national more than a year and a half ago. This is a Declaration of Naturalization Act of July 1779. Recorded, notarized, and this is witnesses. I was born of my parents, which is also recorded in the public record. And my second witness, recorded and in the record. Acknowledgement, acceptance, and deed of reconveyance, recorded and notarized. All right, certificate of assumed name, notice of transfer of reserved name. This is all the names that I ever had from my two previous marriages. Also recorded. And sealed. That was four pages. Then the act of expatriation on every name that I ever had. Each of them are all done. So now it's been recorded in the public twice. It is absolutely breaking the law to address me unless I consent to it, and I don't. And this one is a mandatory notice. Foreign Sovereign Immunities Act, Section 1605 and 1607, Notice of Liability, 18 U.S.C., 2333, 18 U.S.C., 1341, and 1342. Hold up, let me read this top paragraph. This mandatory notice is provided to all territorial United States district and state and county courts, their officers, clerks, bailiffs, sheriffs, deputies, and employees, and all municipal appointees, including their district, state, and county courts, their officers, and employees. This vessel doing business as, and then it gives all the names that I've had in the past. These vessels are publishing mandatory notice that they are foreign sovereigns from the Maryland state of the United States of America. This is your mandatory notice that these above named vessels are owed all material rights, duties, exemptions, insurances, treaties, bonds, agreements, and guarantees, including indemnity and full faith and credit. You are also hereby provided with a mandatory notice that these vessels are not subject to territorial or municipal United States law and are owed the law of peace, Department of the Army, pamphlet 27-161-1, from all territorial and municipal officers and employees who otherwise have no permission to approach or address them. Any harm resulting from trespass upon these vessels or the use of fictitious names or titles related to the to them shall be subject to full commercial liability and penalties. Okay. And that is recorded. Paramount claim of life and the estate of Carolee Bohannon, Burney, Maryland, and then my parents' names. Whereas I, the living woman known as Carolee Bohannon, am the result of the life and love and physical and embodiment of my parents, blah, blah, blah. All right. The afterbirth composed of a placenta, umbilical cord, and fetal tissues which accompanied me into this world and which was in possession of my DNA was never a viable, separate living organism and was instead a portion of my flesh, skin, to any hair, skin, or other representations of my genetic content that was not abandoned, not donated, and not returned to me or my parents for burial. No separate estate, living status, ownership, interest, or death apart from my own life may be claimed in behalf of the afterbirth or other waste resulting from my birth, from my shedding of hair, my shedding of skin, the deposit of my fingerprints, or any other DNA containing substance whatsoever. I hereby establish any paramount claim upon my unique DNA as the only lawful and living inheritor thereof from the moment of my conception forward, and I also publish my nullification of any claim of ownership or material interest in my DNA based upon the samples procured from any bodily waste or substance for any purpose. As a witness to my claims, I here affix the signature and seal of my lawful person, retaining all rights and prerogatives thereof. This is also in the public record. Okay, hold up. Now, I have since made everything known to the county, to the state, some stuff sent to Washington, because the BS has got to stop. But I urge you all to find out how to change your political status so you too can become free. Now, I'm under duress and threat of being arrested should I choose to leave my domicile in my private conveyance, because they said they was going to arrest me, which would be a mistake. Okay, so they have received numerous documents proving my political status, but I was intimidated and threatened with arrest by a United States Marshal, of whom was down here because the FBI agent ended up filing a claim against me and filed an affidavit, which is wishy-washy bullshit, bogus stuff that he filed, because I do have a bona fide accusatory instrument by which they ended up letting me know that it, because I filed the non-commercial private lien against Liberty Mutual and the employees that I have the names on for having done wrong and being in contempt of their court orders to provide my medical care. So it has taken me years to glean and to learn what the right avenue to get justice, because you are daggone sure not going to get it before their court. Their court system is stacked against we the people. Their Article 1 courts of statutes, not law, okay, absolute statutes, which has nothing to do with me, nor the United States Corporation of America, has nothing to do with me. So anyway, and I've got case law from the United States Supreme Court verifying this fact, and so they ended up, Liberty Mutual, Michael Beck or David Long, ended up contacting the district attorney up in Louisville, Kentucky, and trying to pin a extortion claim on the all caps name, Carol Roberts. And they've since added Carol Bohannon. So when he showed up and I looked and viewed the document he had, which was in the all caps name, which has nothing to do with me, the living woman, okay, absolutely nothing. Y'all need to understand and do your investigation to find out what they're pulling here. The all caps name is a fiction. It's a fictitious name, and the only way they can contract with you is if you consent and accept their BS, which I adamantly do not. So I marked a cover page when it blew out in my backyard, and a friend of mine in Hawaii told me, you better back daggone sure you send it back within the 3 days. They can't count the first day, so I did. I sent it back registered mail to the judge, And anyway, I've not heard anything about it. They had their, I had sent a little bit of my 41 pages of documents to this district attorney up in Louisville, showing him that they had no jurisdiction. But he gleaned over it and wrote it off. And I had never heard anything more back, and y'all remember that I had the FBI down here on my front porch in September and in October. So when I sent the documented proof that I'm outside of all their BS, I thought it was a done deal, it was over with and forgot about. But no, because the FBI got involved and he ended up filing a complaint and the affidavit, it took the U.S. Marshal to then come down here wanting to deliver the paperwork, which I vehemently denied to accept. And I told him, which is on a recorder, that I am not who he thinks I am. And he just said, I'm doing my job. Well, isn't that what the freaking Nazis did? I'm just doing my job. These people seem to think that they can dictate to we the people when they cannot. They have no part to do with we the people, the flesh, blood-flowing people. They can't do it without your consent. So you write on there, return to sender, non-assumpsit, which means you do not care to contract. It's an invitation to go to their court and to get wrapped up in all that crap, which I did not go, which was supposed to be on the, the 18th of this month. So I sent 74 documents to them, to the sheriff, to the police department, Sheriff Kane, Keith Kane, Police Department Chief Arthur Elam, to the District Attorney's Office, to the Washington, to the DOJ, and a few other folks up there. So I've not heard word one, but he threatened me when he was here that if I, the living woman, did not show up, they'd be back to arrest me. All right, so let's get on with it. And then the other one, and this is all because I filed the private non-commercial lien against Liberty Mutual for their being in bad faith, breaking the public trust or breaching it, breaching the public trust, and their court orders, which they've been in contempt of for years. So anyhow, they got PO'd, one corporate entity contacted another corporate entity for help. So then they bring these bogus charges and interloping into a private matter, which they damn sure don't have the right to do. All right, so they had received to whom it may concern, the annex notice of intent fee schedule timetable is a scheduled and mandatory fees instated by the secured party creditor Carol Lee Bohannon, authorized representative on behalf of the capital name of Carol Bohannon, Carol L. Bohannon, Carol Lee Bohannon, and etc., etc., and all the other names that they've used. Okay, and any permeation thereof for any business conducted relevant to this schedule, fees are due and must be paid before said business can commence. If invoicing becomes necessary, invoiced amounts are due 15 days and after day of receipt. If said fees are not met, it is the right by the secured party creditor, which is me, Carol E. Bohannon, to refuse or void any form of business interaction and or transaction fees are subject to change at any time without prior notice. Secured party creditor Carolee Bohannon is the only authorized representative to alter, void, and or enforce said fees and may do so at any time. This has been recorded, notarized, and they received this. It was sent out February 26th, and this is the fee schedule of it. It's pretty hefty, you know. Using my license, social security number, name, 50,000. I'm not going to name all this stuff, but it's a hefty one. The driver's license, which is all null and void. It expires this summer, but it doesn't matter. It's null and void and has been for more than a year and a half. All right, social security number, where they got that, I don't know, because I certainly didn't give them any ID when they attempted to arrest me downtown on January 16th, 100,000, but they got me here in my driveway. All right, retinal scans they didn't do, fingerprints, 200,000, photography, 200,000, they didn't do any DNA. Traffic citation, 60,000. Time in court, 75,000 per hour. And it just goes on and on and on. Okay. There's several pages for what all they've done, and some of it doesn't apply to them, like bodily fluids and all that. I think it was $5 million for departing me from my private conveyance. Stealing my video camera and my tape recorder, which I still have not retained back or given back to me. So, anyway, that takes care of that one. All right, this one is notice accommodations list for a real woman who's totally disabled, medical necessities. And this is several pages of what my physical disabilities are, what they'd have to do to accommodate me, because they don't have any accommodations for disabled people. That is 5 pages. Then there's the cases quoted from the United States Supreme Court on that they have no jurisdiction. All right. An illegal arrest is an assault and battery. The person so attempted to be restrained of his liberty has the same right to use force in defending himself as he would in any other assault and battery. Okay. The right to travel, the right to mode of conveyance, the right to locomotion are all absolute rights, and the police cannot make void the exercise of rights. the right of a citizen to travel upon public highways and to transport one's property thereon, either by carriage or automobile, is not a mere privilege which a city may prohibit or permit at will, but is but a common right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. There's a lot of cases in here, people. All right. Here you go. Ibid Gibbons versus Ogden. Reread particularly Article 1, Section 8.1 and 9.1. Persons are not the subjects of commerce, and not being imported goods, they do not fall within the meaning founded upon the Constitution of the power given to Congress to regulate commerce and the prohibition of the states for importing a duty on imported goods. Penhollow versus Dean. Administrations define government succinctly. Governments are corporations, a creature of the mind only. A government can deal only with artificial persons. The imaginary having no reality or substance cannot create or attain parity with the real. That's us, folks. The living, breathing man or woman. All right. No state legislator or executive or judicial officer can war against the Constitution without violating his undertaking to support it. Miranda versus Arizona. Where rights are secured by the Constitution are involved, there can be no rulemaking or legislation which would abrogate them. Marbury versus Madison. The Constitution of the United States is the supreme law of the land, and any law that is repugnant to the Constitution is null and void.